This presentation of Berks County Outdoors is funded by contributing members of the Federated Sportsmen's Clubs of Berks County.
Hello again, and welcome to Berks County Outdoors. We're thinking spring. Last Wednesday's weather really got the spring bug going, and we're going to talk about trout fishing most of the day, and the opening of the season coming up at the end of March, and trout stocking beginning on March the 1st, which is this Thursday. So we've got trout fishing on our mind. Thanks for joining us. I'm Roger Mallon.
And I'm Bob Entler. Welcome to Berks County Outdoors here on BCTV, fourth Monday of the month, 8 o'clock. That's what time it is. 8 o'clock, we're live. You can give us a call if you'd like. 378-0426, 610-378-0426. We'd like to hear from you. Any questions or comments? And we have giveaways tonight. Once again, giveaways here on Berks County Outdoors.
Some good lures.
We got some good lures, yeah. and turkey. Something about turkeys over there. Two are there, Roger.
Yeah.
Right off the bat, Roger, I want to get out the event that's going to be happening on April 14th. It is the Federated Sportsmen's Clubs of Berks County. It is their annual dinner. And those guys, of course, are the sponsors of our program here on BCTV. Now, that will take place again on April 14th at the Virginville Grange. And it's a home-style dinner that you go to. And there's going to be a guest and a presentation by Ben Jones, who is with the Pennsylvania Game Commission. And he's in charge of the habitat planning and development. He's going to be talking about fire and how that will be used to improve and restore habitat.
Control burns.
Yeah. Control burns. Mm. So that is on Saturday, April 14th, the Federation Dinner at the Virginville Grange.
The other thing that's important about that night is that we will be announcing our 2018 Outdoor Sports Person of the Year. I don't know how many years we've been doing it, but it's over 20.
Yes.
And we always make the announcement at the Federation Dinner. So this is an award given to volunteers who give of themselves, their time, their money, their interests towards the outdoors community. And it's on a volunteer basis. So if you know someone who kind of fits that bill, we'd like to hear about them. You can contact us at greatdayoutdoors.com.
Okay, Roger, before we go any farther, we're going to give stuff away right now.
Okay, that works, yeah.
So we have some trout lures here. Trout season is just around the corner, and I have a little package of four trout lures.
They're good ones.
Which include two spinners.
Panther
one
Martins.
Is the rooster tail, and let's see if we can get a close-up of that. Maybe we can get Corinne to do a little close-up here for us. We have the rooster tail there, and
those are all good lures.
Yeah, yeah. And then you go to buy these. These are $4 each. We also have a underspin, like a crappie jig,
yeah.
Or you could use that for trout too. Sure. And then we also have the ever popular Castmaster, that is an Antietam special, right? Like Antietam special for trout. So you can call in right now, 378-0426. All four of these lures are going to be yours, that you would come down here to BCTV, the office and the studio, right there. Where are we? 13th and Rockland, somewhere around there, right? Yeah, I hear that phone ringing. That's good. And stay tuned. I got five more things to give away here tonight. Don't go anywhere. There's nothing much good on TV right now anyway. So
yeah, I want to remind you that trout season, the stocking, preseason stocking begins on Thursday this week. And we've got the caller ready.
We got a home viewer.
Hello there.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Who do we got? What's your name?
Seth Fisher.
Jeff Fisher.
Correct.
And boy, that's a perfect name.
Jeff, what? Why are you calling?
I'm watching your show for the first time here, and I'm interested in your lures.
Okay, great. Jeff, where do you live? What area?
Burnville.
Are you going? Are you going trout fishing?
I'm hoping to.
Yeah, all right. Northkill up there?
Yep, correct.
Yeah, good stream. Good stream up there.
Yeah, a lot of good holes.
You have your license?
I'm getting it this week.
Okay, and how are you going to get it?
Probably going up to Race Snyder's.
Well, you can do that, but one other thing you can do is you can go...
a better idea for you.
You can go online on the Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission website, buy your license there with a card, and then you print your own out. And when you go to print out, you can print out multiple copies so that when you go out there and you lose one, you've got backup. And you don't have to pay to get the extra one where you would have to pay it if you go to a store.
Perfect.
All right?
Give it a try.
Thank you.
All right. Well, listen, Jeff, I'm gonna put a little tag in here. This is your bag of trout lures, and don't go anywhere because I got more stuff to give away here. And we got a special guest with us tonight that's going to talk about trout fishing and fly fishing in particular. Roger, who do we got? Well, thanks, Jeff.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah,
all
thanks
right.
for calling. Good luck this season. Our guest tonight is Vinny Dick Jr. He's been on the program before. He writes for us in the Reading Eagle. And the way to contact him is tobeonthewater.com. The number two, the letter B, onthewater.com. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
he's an excellent fly tyer, and he's going to do some demonstrations tonight for us with the tying flies.
He's busy at work over there tying them up right now. He's probably going to give a couple of them away, too. Right, Vinny?
So what's your thoughts about the trout season coming?
I think it's going to be an exceptional season.
Why?
Lots of water this year.
Lots of water.
Snow, lots of rain, yeah. Creeks are going to be full. Fish are going to move around. They're not going to be stuck in pools.
Right.
It's going to be outstanding. Yeah.
But you fish all year long for trout.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Right now, you can still go out and fish right now until the season closes anywhere. But then once season closes, you'll pull out trout streams, which that's a whole different, that's a different ball of wax.
Okay, well, when do the streams close? Let's get that start
March
there.
March the 1st.
March 1st.
This Thursday,
they're
the
done.
Streams will close.
It's top to
until
bottom.
The opening on the 31st of March, the opening day of trout.
Okay.
The 24th of March will be the Mentored Youth Trout Fishing Day, so the streams will be open then. You can go fishing there and with your family and with the kids and have a good time alone on the streams. Week later, the 31st, that's when the season opens. So between March 1st and the 31st, no fishing is allowed with three exceptions. The wild trout streams that Vinny's talking about, Kersher Creek Lake, or Kersher Creek Dam, and the Lower Tully, the delayed harvest stretch of the Lower Tully, plus below the covered bridge all the way down to the confluence with the Schuylkill River.
Now that's catch and release only.
Yeah.
Immediate release. You
cannot
can fish.
Keep fish during this period.
All right.
Yeah, can't
make
do
sure
it.
You got that.
Also, a note that this year, for the first time and maybe ever, Kersher Creek Dam will be stocked with trout this spring. It'll be toward the end of the month. I think it's like the 27th of March. Kersher Creek will be stocked. Typically, it's stocked in the fall for ice fishing, really, for the winter season. But this year, for the first time, it will be stocked in the spring. So keep that in mind because that can be a easy access and popular stream for fishing or popular lake for fishing. So it's all going to start Monday. The first stream is Saucony and Mill and Willow Creek. They're all going to be stocked this Thursday. You can go out and help them out and enjoy that part of the experience. That,
Roger, you have the the listings of all of the stockings.
Yeah, 2 weeks ahead of time, I'm publishing them in the Reading Eagle in the Sunday page. So
and like Roger said, you can and you have the meeting times on
and
there,
the
right?
Meeting times and places and the streams that'll be stocked. So if you want to get acquainted with where they're putting the fish, this is a good way to do it. Plus, it's a great thing for kids.
And help do it. Help. Yeah,
sure. Carry a bucket down the
street. Get in line. There's usually a stack of about 20 cars there that are following that truck around. And then you run up to the truck and the guy gets a bucket full of fish and you take it down to your stream, your favorite fishing hole, and you put, put that one in there.
Yeah, they really cater to the kids. But let's, Vinny.
Yes, sir.
For months now, you've been filing Facebook messages and so forth about this squirmy wormy thing.
Yes.
The pink worm.
It's a very simple fly to tie.
Yeah, but you're telling me that it's killer.
It is killer. Well, the killer thing is the Berkeley trout worm. I tried talking to Bob about this. This stuff here, I've been fishing this for 10 years. No matter where any stream I've gone on, we've hammered trout. Now, to fish this with a fly rod, like I said, I like to get a big crappy hook, the true turn hook, so it's longer. So if the fish does take it deeper, you pop it and comes right out.
There's it has no a longer shank.
Yeah, longer shank to it.
Okay.
No hurt, not going to hurt the fish. But then someone came up with a genius idea to make some kind of rubber stuff called squirmy wormies. Come in various sizes, or I shouldn't say sizes, various colors. But they're all about, it's probably about 5 inch long, and it's just a little squiggly thing.
That's like soft plastic.
Very soft plastic. And what
it looks
I do.
Like it's biodegradable, too. I bet it is. So what do you do with it?
What I do is you just pluck one of these off, just like that, and I'll take it. Instead of putting that much on there, I like it to be about maybe 2.5 to 3 inches.
The same length as?
Those are the trout worms. They're 3 inches. So what I do is I take it, just cut it in half, and then I'll lash it on a hook. Now, when you put this on a hook, you want to be careful because you could cut right through it if you apply too much pressure. Okay. You'll cut right through it and cut in half.
All right, so now give us the details. Now, what kind of hook you got there?
That is a size 10 scud hook.
Okay.
It's bigger, like I said, because they suck these in. It looks like a worm. They take these. They just suck it right in. So I'm not kidding.
It's a little rounded. Scud hooks are a little rounded.
And it's bigger. It's easier for us to get out.
Okay,
all right, and suck in herbs much.
Okay, now what's the first thing you did there?
Laying down base layer of thread. I like to use paint because it matches. All right. And then what I'll do is I'll take a piece that I cut in half, and I'll just try and lash it on there. A couple wraps around. And it likes to twist. And what I do is I like to go around almost like a figure eight to kind of lock it into place so it's not going to go anywhere anymore. Then I like to put a breeding collar on it. Some guys will just lay the thread down and leave it there. That's not good enough for me.
Okay.
I like to put a breeding collar on it. So you can use pink. I'm going to use pink fluorescent polyseal. And it gives a nice little good look to it.
So this the collar you're talking about is on a regular worm.
Yes, sir.
That like when you look at a worm, it's got that
it's their breeding
flattened
color.
Air.
Yep, breeding color. It's usually orangey, brownish, depending on the worm.
Okay.
Now with the Berkeley trout worms, I've done well with pink, orange, and yellow. But with brown and like the tan ones, nothing.
You're kidding.
Look like a worm and nothing. But you use pink or orange and it's like, whoa, the world's on fire. So then we're gonna take that dubbing, wrap it around nice and easy.
Yeah.
And just get a big ball there. And this will help too if it'll catch in its teeth more than the squirmy wormy will. But this is not, I mean, you wanna fly it, it's simple to tie.
Yeah.
This is about as simple as it gets.
It's simple. Now, so then when you do, you fish that on your fly rod.
Yes, sir.
And are you using any weight with that?
I will add a split shot, usually a BB or two or maybe a 3-0. It depends on what the water is. If it's ripping, put a 3-0 on, 12 inches, 18 inches up. Or two little BBs, depends what it is.
All right. Now, can you fish this on just a regular spinning rod?
No, without a doubt. My son does it all the time. He does it for bat. Well, he does it with the Berkeley trout worms. And then I've done it this year for ice fishing. Instead of tipping my jigs with waxies or mousies or whatever, live bait, I was tipping them with this. And it was game on. I pulled out a 13-inch yellow perch.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Big beautiful. I'm like, wow, that's
beautiful. Were you at Onalani?
Onalani, Peters Creek Cove. It was the best fight I've ever had ice fishing. It ran and ran and ran, and then it got caught in vegetation. So I had to, like, hand line pull it in.
Yeah, right.
A little bit of time to put on the reel. And I got in, I'm like, wow, this is one of the most beautiful fish I've ever
caught. They are beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, it was beautiful fish.
Were there many guys out ice fishing this year?
Yes, sir. Most of the year. Yeah. I don't know if you got out at all, so you were too busy down south staying warm and fishing for bass and all that. We're up here freezing. Bob's out having a good old time. Well, we had that. We had probably 2 or 3 weeks of that really super cold weather.
Yeah, right.
Great.
There were people ice fishing everywhere. Yep. Even up towards the end. I'm not a planker. If you got a plank to get on, I'm not going on.
No.
Not happening. No.
And there's plenty of guys that do that.
Oh, they do.
Yeah. But Vinny's talking about taking out actually a 12-inch wide board because around the edges of the shoreline, the ice is gone. So you got to put a bridge across to get out onto the ice.
Some of the guys, you'll have 80% of the lake will be open. They'll be wanting to get on that 20% of ice because that's where the fish are. Yeah. They're under that little iceberg. I don't know. Not for me. I'm not dying over a 2-inch bluegill.
Yeah, it's true.
Not happening. Not at all.
Well, that's a fisherman for you, huh?
Yeah.
So you've got.
Yep.
Well, let's describe what you got there.
Well, we got some squirmy wormies and the other fly, which is going to be the March article for Red Eagle, the B-tail caddis.
Yeah.
These, you go to any craft store, and you'll find, they're called seed beads. They come in various sizes.
Oh, yeah. Various sizes. Those are glass beads, right?
Yes. Yep, seed beads. And then those are smaller ones. They have the bigger ones, too. This is...
Well, how do
for, you, I use them for steelhead, the color
do
ones.
Do you just thread them onto the hook?
Yes, sir.
They go past the...
Well, you can. There's a lot of ways you can use the beads. The bigger ones, most definitely, you can slide on the hook.
Right past the barb,
and
it goes in.
You put dubbing behind it, and then tie the head in the front, and you got a nice bead body caddis. I like the bead tail where I'm using, you can use your tying thread. You can use, actually what I like using is the rod tying thread, Gudibrod. It's still flimsy, but it's when you tie a knot, it stays tied. It doesn't come apart on you. Put a little bit of head cement on it, and you're good to go. And what I'll do is I'll put here. Look at this one here.
So what you're saying is that you are using these beads for the tail.
Yes, sir.
Rather than the head.
And what you do is, I don't know if they could get on that. You tie the one bead on the end, and then you put three or four beads slide over the thread.
Mm-hmm. And then what? Get that?
And then what we're doing is we're gonna lash the bead tail down onto the hook, add some dubbing, and basically you have a killer caddis larva pattern. And with the different colored beads, like there's 15, 20 different shades of olive. You can mix and match. Like each segment can be a little different, and you can cater it to whatever caddis you have in your stream. I mean, caddis, there's all kinds of olives, greens, creams, October caddis, a little bit of orange in there. I mean, there's many different ways you can tie this, and it's still gonna look awesome. And again, it's not hard. The hardest thing is threading this on.
Once
threading it on. Right. But what I normally do is I'll do like 25, 30 of them. I'll let them all sit there, and then I'll just one at a time, just go through them and get them done. But I doing one of these for every fly, for every hook, is just a pain in the butt. So I like to try as many as I can sitting there. 30 of them sitting there, I'm going to tie 30 of them. We're good to go.
All right, Vinny, let me interrupt you because we're going to give another batch of those trout lures away. Once again, let me get back over here. We got five, what do we got in here? I think we have five different.
That looks like your tackle box.
Yeah, it looks like a lot like that. All the hooks together. Now it's on my sweater there. Okay, so now we've had it, actually, and I forgot that we had that in there. Let's see, this is that little Cleo, a tiny little Cleo. That's like an 8-ounce little Cleo.
That's a good trout lure.
Yeah, that'll work there. So that's going to go away. 3780426, call now. Call now. Now we have the rooster tail that's going to go with that. Then we have the little bit of like a crappy jig underspin. And then we have the Castmaster. And then, of course, we have, what's that one there, Roger?
Panther Martin.
Why can't I can never remember that?
Those are my favorites.
Now keep in mind, guys, guys that use spinners, when you use a spinner like this, you've got to use a swivel.
Yeah.
You've got to use a swivel with it because these spinners keep going around like that. If you don't have a swivel, that's going to make your line go
around like that.
You go to take a cast, all of a sudden, whoop, not so good.
Yeah.
So 3780426. Call in now. Jeff, you can call in again. I don't care.
We're going to
whoever's out there.
Couple of announcements we need to get in. We have a viewer.
Oh, all right. Okay, we got people watching tonight. All right. Vinny, are these your friends?
Hello. I don't know.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
What's your name?
My name is Scarlett.
Scarlett.
Scarlett. And Scarlett, what can I do for you?
I was just calling for the giveaway, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Do you like to fish?
Yes, I do.
Do you?
Where do you fish, Scarlett?
Most of the time I go with my boyfriend. His name's Colin. I think he's watching right now.
All right. Hi, Colin.
We've gone to Antietam to go trout fishing. And there's a stream near his house, Cocoozing.
Oh, yeah.
Easter, I think it is.
Uh-huh, yeah. Sure, yeah.
And we've caught a good amount of trout out of there.
Good. Well, you've got some great lures here. Just got to come and pick them up.
Scarlett, what's your last name, Scarlett?
Oxenford.
Say it again?
Oxenford.
Oxenford. Okay. All right. I'm going to put that your name right here on that little slip. It's going in that bag. And you come down to we only have 5 minutes left. Okay.
Yeah.
So listen, I got one more thing I'm going to give away.
Let me get these announcements.
All right, you're again. But yeah. One more thing, you can call now. Hang up. Start fresh in there. Go ahead, Roger.
Yeah, three things I got to mention. The Fish and Boat Commission is having a series of forums around the state, asking anglers their opinions about the future of fishing in Pennsylvania. The closest one to our area is March the 10th at the Greater Philadelphia Show. The boat show down there at the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center in Oaks. That's March the 10th. The Blue Mountain chapter of the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation will have their annual banquet, and it's always a good one. It's going to be at Leesport Farmers Market this year. That's a change of venue, 4:30 p.m., and the date is March the 17th. And then finally, the Reading Archery Club will hold its Arrows for Autism fundraiser. That's on March 17th and 18th at the Reading Archery Club from 7 a.m. to noon.
Roger, do we have the information about the Berks County fly tires? Is that in there?
That's here, yeah.
Okay, now if you want to learn how to tie flies, just like Vinny's doing over here.
Yeah, that starts March the 6th, but you got to get in on it right away to let, you know, to make a reservation. The Berks County Fly Tires will hold a fly tying series of classes between March 6th and April 10th. Limited number of people can make it into the class, so call in advance. Jim Tucker, and then the phone number's in the Sunday Reading Eagle, but I'll give it to you again, 610-777-0652.
Yeah, the Berks County Fly Tires, good organization. They help us out here through our auction. Now, okay, we have a caller. Hello.
Hi.
Hello, caller.
Turn your TV down.
Are you there?
Nope. No.
Joan, nobody there?
I'll grab another one.
Okay, last chance. Call in now, 378-0426. 378-0426. Hurry up. You only got about 2 minutes. Okay, Vinny, how you doing over there?
I'm tying up your jig, yes.
You're tying up a jig for me, hair jig.
We're getting there. We're getting there.
Nice. You're doing because great over there.
The thing with hair jigs is, guess what? They don't have to be too pretty. You can be as sloppy as you want to be, and guess what? It's still going to be very effective fly.
I use those hair jigs for bass fishing. I hear the phone going in there, so we might have somebody that's going to give, we're going to find out if they fish for bass or if they fish for trout. What do you do? Don't forget about our radio show, Sunday mornings on WEEU, Great Day Outdoors. We talk about all this kind of stuff, all the latest information. Make sure you check out Roger's page, the Reading Eagle, the hunting and fishing every Sunday. Yeah. Reading Eagle, great information on that all the time. Those phones are going.
Let's bring somebody up here.
All right, let's see. What else we got going, Roger? Oh, how about the Isaac Walton League, you guys, bass fishing? The Isaac Walton League Bass Tournament out of Blue Marsh Lake will be taking place on the April 7th. Yes. On April 7th is the Isaac Walton League. And then the week before, on the 31st of March, is the Berks Bassmasters Open Buddy Tournament out of Blue Marsh Lake. Okay, now we got that home viewer. Who do we got? Oh, we don't have
him. Lost him. Okay.
Oh, we lost him. Oh, all boy. Right. Well, then we're going to have to save him for next time. I think we're about out
just
of time, Joan, aren't
town,
we?
Yeah. How's that coming along there, Vinny?
Okay. Almost.
Yeah. Okay. Those are easy to tie, but boy, they're effective. Yeah.
And I would like to put a big old collar on here
now,
to make it easier.
If people go to your website, tobeonthewater.com,
they
can buy flies from you?
There's a section on there called Vin's Bug Shop.
Vin's Bug Shop.
They click on that, and they'll have my trout flies, eBay auction, stuff like that. But what I like to do, what I cater to most, is custom orders.
I was just going to ask
you. So if somebody wants flies, you just tell me what you want. I tell you the price, and I cater it, because I want everybody to be happy. I don't cheat anybody. I make sure everybody's happy.
All right, we got that home viewer. Hello, are you there? Home viewer.
Hello?
Yes, I am.
Okay, what's your name? Quick!
My name is Colin.
Colin! I bet you know, what's her name?
The other one!
Okay, yeah. Colin, are you a trout fisherman or bass fisherman?
I do both.
Okay,
I have
bass lures, or we're going to give you Vinny's lures that he did, the flies that he tied up there. Which one?
The bass one.
Okay, I got two bass lures here for you, all right? We're going to put your name in there. Colin, thanks for calling in. Tune in next month. At our next program, we're going to have more stuff to give away. Every week, every month, we're giving stuff away here. BCTV, Berks County Outdoors. Roger, what do you got going there? Anything left?
Yeah, join us on the radio on WEEU Sunday mornings at 7 a.m., will you please? We talk about this and a whole lot more. So thanks for joining us. We'll see you outdoors. Thank you.
This presentation of Berks County Outdoors is funded by contributing members of the Federated Sportsmen's Clubs of Berks County.